Hello, my name is Laura Brown with the Williams & Brown Law Firm. My law practice is focused on birth injury, which are injuries that are suffered by babies at or near the time of birth and often result in cerebral palsy. Today I want to explain the four types of cerebral palsy. A lot of people don't know that there are different kinds of cerebral palsy, and it can be confusing when a medical professional or a family member is talking to you about cerebral palsy using words that you're not familiar with. Today, I'm going to break down the different kinds of cerebral palsy and explain what that medical jargon means. There are four major types of cerebral palsy: spastic, athetoid, ataxic, and mixed. These different categories are used to describe how a person's brain damage affects their overall mobility. Each kind of cerebral palsy is categorized using two factors: the type of movement problems a person has and the areas of the body where the person is affected. Cerebral palsy often impacts muscle tone, which means it impacts the strength and the tension of the muscles. Two terms you might have heard are hypotonia and hypertonia. The hypo in hypotonia means low muscle tone, which means the person suffers a loss of strength and firmness in their muscles. The hyper in hypertonia means high muscle tone. The person suffers from rigidity and spasmodic movement. The most common type of CP is spastic cerebral palsy. About 70 to 80% of children have this form of CP. People who have spastic CP often have exaggerated or jerky movements caused by the hypertonia, which remember means having high muscle tone that causes this rigidity. Spastic CP is the result of damage to the brain's motor cortex and damage to the pyramidal tracts, which are responsible for sending signals to the muscles. The next type of CP is athetoid cerebral palsy. About 10% of children have this kind of CP, and these children are often considered non-spastic. They may suffer from a mix of hypertonia and hypotonia, and the child may move involuntarily in the face, the torso, and limbs. The third type is ataxic CP, and about 10% of children have ataxic CP. It's caused by damage to the cerebellum, and it affects the child's coordination and balance. Those children may also have trouble speaking. The fourth type of CP is mixed cerebral palsy. Less than 10% of children have mixed CP, which is caused by multiple injuries in the brain. These children may often show symptoms of a combination of spastic and athetoid cerebral palsy. So that summarizes the four major types of cerebral palsy: spastic, athetoid, ataxic, and mixed. Remember, these different categories are used to describe how a person's brain damage affects their overall mobility. In my next video, I'll break down how these diagnoses are related to movement problems around the body.